Morphos are these big, flashy, beautiful butterflies. They're in the family Nymphalidae, which is the same family that monarchs are in. We wouldn't see morphos in Minnesota, but if we were in the tropical rainforests of Central or South America, we might see them flying around. Here's a morpho in the wild. Many of the morpho applications are still in development, but they're really wide-ranging. They mostly have to do with light and light applications, but in ways that you might not expect. So for example, revising the structure of solar cells to more effectively capture light. There's even some applications where people are building anti-counterfeiting devices and money that kind of reflect the light in ways that are really hard to mimic. There are people looking at windows and screen design and how you might change the structure of those screens or windows to reflect some light or absorb some light depending on the environment that you're in. So how did we start to get into some of the basic knowledge of morphos? Some of the oldest papers that they're referencing actually come from the third Baron Rayleigh. At the very end of his life, he started taking animals from his garden and probably from an insect collection somewhere and just asking, why are they that color? He was the one who first started to think about, well, maybe this isn't a pigment, but this is something else, this is structure. Coloration in animals can be pigment-based, it can also be structural. So the black edges of this wing are pigment-based. It's a melanin-based color, and so it looks black. There's nothing being reflected to us. Whereas the blue color, this kind of shiny iridescent color, there's no blue pigment in this wing. The structures there are reflecting the light in a very specific way so that it makes this shiny iridescent blue. So while my lab is not working directly on morphos, we are very much inspired by this idea of taking how the biological traits work and then potentially in the future translating them into some kind of application.